Hello, YouTube, and welcome to the first episode of the Raspberry Pi series. Well, I should say the official first episode of the Raspberry Pi series. So, unless you've lived under a rock, the Raspberry Pi is a very useful and tiny computer. It's about the size of your hand, all right? And it's got a lot of input and output pins, GPIO, that can be connected to different things, read switches, control things by I2C, video cameras. It can do a lot, all right? And we're going to set it up, and we're going to learn how to program it. So this video, the first in the series, we're going to discuss basically what the Raspberry Pi is and how to get a basic operating system onto it. And then in future videos, we'll start exploring it. And when I say exploring it, I do honestly mean exploring it, because I'm starting out the same as you are. And as I learn, I'll teach you. And then if you've got some ideas or tricks for me, let me know in the comments down below, and I'll be more than glad to work on these things and expand both of our knowledge. And I hope we all have fun in the process. Anyway, the Raspberry Pi is a small computer, and like any computer, it needs to have an operating system. Your computer on your desktop or your laptop has a hard drive. In place of a hard drive, we're going to use a micro SD. Now, I can put anywhere from an 8 gig up to like a 64 gig. I've found that for my uses, a 16 gigabyte is fine. They're available on Amazon for 5 of them for $20. And the nice thing is, I can program multiple SD cards so that if I have a string of programming on one of them and I've got it set up the way I want for one particular task, and then I want to do something radically different, I can simply switch the SD cards and have a different operating system and a different setup. So that's very handy in my opinion. Also, it means that if I get something set up exactly the way I want it, there's a cloning routine. I can clone to another SD card and make an exact duplicate of the one that I've got. So that way it's very easy to reproduce once you've got it set up the way you want it. Anyway, to get the operating system, we're going to go online, and there's a unique little tool that'll do all the hard work for you. Then we'll insert the chip into the Raspberry Pi, apply power, and we'll go through the settings together on the screen. So let's get started.
We're going to go to raspberrypi.org/software, okay? And that's going to bring us to the Raspberry Pi operating system. Now, they've got this little guy right here, which is an installer. And to get the installer, you just download it for your particular operating system. Once you've done that, we run it, and it will write the SD card. So let's go ahead and do that now. If you have a micro SD card slot in your PC, or if you've got an SD card slot, you can put this into the adapter like that and plug it into your micro SD slot. If you don't, you're going to need one of these. It's an adapter which turns it into basically a thumb drive. So what you'll do is you'll take this and plug it into the proper slot, which is this one. And now we can take this and plug it into the laptop. When we do, the software will identify it, and then we can go ahead and load the operating system. After we've finished downloading the software, we run it, and it will install this unit right here. We choose our storage, and you notice it did find our 16 gigabyte device. So we tell it that's what we want, and then we choose the operating system. And in our case, we're going to use the standard Raspberry Pi operating system. Once you do that, all you have to do is click on Write. It's going to warn you that everything on there is going to be erased. Tell it yes. And at this point, all we have to do is wait for it to finish. And then when it finishes, we can go ahead and install it into the Raspberry Pi. Now that it's finished doing the upload to the chip, it's going to verify that the contents it uploaded and wrote to the chip are working correctly. Once it's finished verification, then the chip will be ready to use. Oh, well, doesn't that just suck? That means we've got to format it and try again. Happens sometimes, though. You know what? Let's turn this into a plus. So what do you do if you have an SD card, or a micro SD card, I should say, that doesn't work? Well, come up to here, and instead of selecting an operating system, go all the way down to the bottom and click on Erase. And then make sure you choose the storage over again and hit Write. It's going to say, you sure you want to do that? Tell it yes. Now it has been erased. So now that it's been erased, we can go up here and select this. Make sure we choose the device and tell it to write over again. So after we format, this time it went through. This is the message that you should get. And now that we've got the message, we simply hit continue. We'll eject the SD card and we're ready to install it into the Raspberry Pi. Once the SD card is finished writing, take it out of the protective SD case, go to the back of your Raspberry Pi, and insert it just like this. Now you may notice that I've got a protective plastic case for mine. I do a lot of things and I don't want something to accidentally fall onto the sensitive electronics. So I've got these little cases and they're available from multiple different places. And I just think it makes it a lot better. Your Raspberry Pi is protected. You're less likely to get anything on it that damages it. So now that we've got this in here, what we're going to do is we're going to plug in a mouse, a keyboard, the HDMI connector, and 5 volts power. Once we do that, we're ready to turn it on, and our Raspberry Pi should boot up and be ready to go. Raspberry Pi just booted up with our new SD. We hit next, and it's going to ask where your location is. And I happen to be in the United States, so that's what I'll select. Then it asks me which language and which time zone, and for me, I am in Central Time. Then I'm going to tell it use the English language and use a US keyboard. Your system may vary depending on where you're at. Now I've got a low voltage warning up here. It's due to my power supply. I need to get a more powerful power supply. You probably won't get that warning, so just ignore it. If you enter a password in here, don't forget it. Put something in you're going to remember, even if it's something as simple as 1234. Okay? I do a lot of things with CNC computers, so I'm just going to go CNC, and I'm going to go CNC. It just works for me. Alright, now, you see how there's a black border around the screen? I'm going to tell it I see a black border, and it'll make an adjustment. Now it's going to look for networks. So it found a bunch of networks. There's my network right there. I'm going to tell it to go ahead and connect to it. And I'll put my password in. Alright, hit next. Now it'll try to connect to the Wi-Fi network. Okay, now we're going to tell it to go ahead and check and see if anything needs to be updated. So it'll take a look, synchronize the clock. Almost 10 minutes to do the download to update the system. Now what it's doing is it's doing an install. And then once it finishes that, we'll get to the next step. So now we're all ready to go. So we're going to hit restart. And when we do, the Raspberry Pi will restart and our settings will take effect. And it takes a little while for it to boot. Hard drive, it's an SD card, it's a little bit slower. We now have our Raspberry Pi. It's totally configured and it's ready for you to go. Now, if you're going to program in something like Python, you can come up here under Programming, and they've already got Thani preloaded for you. Just click on it,
The IDE will come up and you can start writing your own programs. You're ready to go. That's all there is to setting up the Raspberry Pi. In our next issue, we will set up a programming language called Gambus, and then we'll explore that. So I look forward to seeing you then, and I hope you enjoy the video. Thank you.